So the next experiment is free emphasis and de-emphasis. Okay, so before into the experiment, first we have to know what is the purpose of pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, right? So as early covered in the theory, so the main purpose of pre-emphasis is to try to boosting up the high frequency components, right? Because in the communications, so then the effect of noise is highly dominating at higher frequencies than lower frequencies, because the message signal having having the signal strength at lower frequencies better, and lower at higher frequencies the strength is lower, right? So please look at some pictorial form I mentioned roughly. So please look at, this is some message signal, the spectrum of the particular message signal, right? If you look at the spectrum of a signal, it is having higher strength at lower levels, low frequency levels. If you look at the high frequency levels, it is maintaining a very low strength of power, right? So if you take some example of the noise, the effect of noise, here I considering AWGN, additive white Gaussian noise, right? Because why we are going to consider here this type of noise is because it's maintaining the effect of noise is throughout its spectrum is constant, right? So in the process of transmission of this particular message through the communication system, this effect of noise is taken place through the channel, right? So if you both are, if these both are added, right, so the resultant effect of the particular modulated signal or particular signal after passing through channel, this is the taken place, right? So if you look at this combination of these two, at low frequency levels the message signal is dominating, so that there is no problem, the effect of noise is less. Okay, if you look at the high frequency levels, so the effect of noise is higher, so that the noise is dominating the original signal. Okay, so this is not at all acceptable. Okay, so this is the problem arised. So in this situation we are going to use the concept of pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, so that we are going to boost up or boosting the high frequency components greater than this particular noise. Okay, so that what is happening is the effect of noise we are trying to minimize, right? So once boosting up the noise, so you may look in the next picture, so that whatever the low frequency low strength signal at higher frequency components, so we are going to artificially boosting these high frequency components so that the effect of noise is minimized at the transmitter level. So once this is you are done, when you pass through channel, so the effect of noise is not taken place because your message signal strength is higher than this particular noise. Okay, so that pre-emphasis we are going to done at the transmitter to boosting up the high frequency components, right? At the receiver end we are going to use the de-emphasis so as to get back the message signal back, which is simply the reverse process of this particular pre-emphasis. Okay, this is the main theme of why we are going to use the pre-emphasis, right? So please look at next the circuit diagram portion. So this is the circuit diagram of pre-emphasis, this is the circuit diagram of pre-emphasis. So this is the signal generator where we are going to transmit the audio signal. Here considering the audio signal, which consists of some 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz signal we are going to generate, and we are going to pass to set of these stages, right? So here it is a some sort of resistor and capacitor divided network we are going to use. So when lower frequencies, at lower frequencies, so the capacitor should going to be open, right? So the signal is passing through the stages, and whenever this signal frequency is higher, so this should be short, so that it is going to be provided through this, so that at higher frequencies we are going to boost up the this particular higher frequency component. That boosting up is taken place with the help of this op amp with a set of gain of this particular, if you look at the gain is provided with the help of, you know already, so RF by R1, the feedback resistor value is greater than this particular input resistor value, so that that amount of gain we are going to apply to the input signal. So here in this experiment we required a set of components required, so capacitors and a set of resistors, and we required 741 op amp along with that a few connecting wires, and also we require the equipment required the particular function generator. So here we have a different frequency range selector switches, and you can control this particular switches, and you are going to control the amplitude of this particular signal also. So here we have chance to generate the different type of signals also. So here I am going to generate a sinusoidal signal with the help of this function generator, and we are going to use a breadboard for making the connections of the particular preemphasis circuit diagram, and we required power supply to drive this particular op amp. So I require the plus or minus 12 volts, so that is I am going to generate with the help of this power supply. And we are also, in order to observe the input waveforms and output waveforms, right, so I am going to use the CRO oscilloscope I am going to use, right. So now look at the connections I am going to, whatever we circuit we discuss till now, so this circuit, same circuit I am going to develop in this particular breadboard. So please look at here the circuit. So I am going to develop the whatever this for this particular is function generator input. So I am going to supply it to this particular circuit. I am going to make the connections as per this circuit diagram. Okay, please follow the connections. So the procedure is simply whatever the circuit we preamplifier circuit we discuss, the circuits, the connections are made as per the particular circuit diagram. So series connections, parallel connections, please follow that. And to drive the particular input signal from the function generator, I am going to drive it here, and the output I am going to take it this particular to the CRO from the IC. Okay. So first connect the circuit, the first step connect the circuit as per the particular whatever the circuit diagram. And in the second stage, second step, so we are going to apply the sinusoidal signal, we are going to apply the sinusoidal input signal, this function generator, and note down this particular peak to peak amplitude and keep the amplitude we are going to fix. Okay, so the amplitude here we are going to develop the 2 volts amplitude, right, and the frequencies depending upon the requirement. So here we are going to keep some frequency 3.8 kilohertz, right. So you can change the frequency as per your requirement from the 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, right. Okay, after that there is the first step we are going to, second step we are going to generate the sinusoidal signal and note down the particular what is the amplitude of that signal. In the third step, vary the particular frequency of the input signal, so the range should be from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Okay, so that variation with the help of the knob we are going to take in place in the particular function generator. Okay, so if you look at the, if you vary the particular input signal, so we are going to look at the changes, so we are going to observe the changes in the particular CRO. The first waveform, the green one, sorry, the yellow one is the input signal and the lower one is the output signal, right. So we can observe the particular amplitude variations, right. So if you go on increasing this particular frequency of the input signal, so what happen is we are going to boosting, right, the strength of the signal. So the definition and the purpose of the circuit is fulfilled here, right. So because low frequency, at the lower frequencies, so the strength of the signal is almost equal to input signal frequency, right. As you are go on increasing the input signal frequency, so you may observe the changes in the strength of the signal. Okay, so changing the strength of the signal is nothing but you are going to boosting the input signal frequency, input signal strength artificially with the help of this preemphasis circuit, right. So our basic theme is fulfilled. So whatever the task is, you are going to note it down, this particular output amplitude levels. So please look at amplitude levels are increasing. So 2 to 2.4, 2.8, 3.7, like that the amplitude should be varied. So that in the fourth step we are going to note it down the output amplitude values of the preamplifier circuit at each value of the input signal frequency. That is from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, you are going to increase the value step by step. 20 hertz, 100 hertz, 500 hertz, 1000, 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz, 5 kilohertz, 10 kilohertz, 20 kilohertz, like that. you are going to, in the 20 steps, you are going to increase the frequency of the input signal so that you are going to note it down the corresponding output voltage for a fixed value of input voltage. So in the last step, you are going to calculate the gain for the each and every variation of the frequency variation of the input signal. So you are going to calculate the gain of this particular circuit. Okay, so once you draw this particular graph, so you are going to get the graph like this, right? So for a constant input signal frequency, you are going to get the output voltage is equal to input voltage, so the gain is 1, right? In decibels, it should be 20 log V0 by Vin. So 20 log V0 by Vin, if you maintain the constant same value, so 20 log 1 is nothing but 0, right? Once you are going to vary the input signal frequency, what happens is, so slowly the strength of the signal, output signal strength of the signal is increased. As the frequencies go on increases, so the strength of the signal is increases. That increments we are going to draw in decibels, right? If you want smooth curve, so then you are going to take more number of frequency variations from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So in this way, we are going to get the frequency response. So if you tabulate the things, so we have the tabular, the frequency variation from 20 to 20 kHz, more number of steps you are going to take, and input voltage is fixed voltage. So in this case, I am going to take 2 volts, and I am going to note it down for the corresponding frequency changes, I am going to note it down the output voltage. Okay. So if I do the gain calculations, 20 log V0 by V nothing but the gain calculation. So if you want smooth curve, you are going to take more number of samples. Okay. So in that way, we are going to obtain the free emphasis. Okay. So de-emphasis is nothing but it is a simply the reverse process. So whatever we done artificial boosting in the pre-emphasis circuit, the reverse process we are going to done in the de-emphasis circuit, right? If you look at the connections point of view, simply we are going to hear some sort of high pass thing we are going to do. Here we are going to do the low pass filter type thing we are going to develop. The remaining things are same. Okay. So if you plot this particular response, so we are going to get the de-emphasis is like this, right? So the reverse process, whatever that happened in the pre-emphasis circuit, the reverse thing is happened in the de-emphasis. Okay. Thank you.